Problem is to write a Python program to create a countdown timer. Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain, and in this video we will learn how to write a program in Python that will allow us to create a countdown timer. Now guys, what is countdown timer? Suppose if you have seen in your mobile phones, you have seen a stopwatch, right? That you give some seconds and it gives you a countdown. That means suppose you have given a second, 5 seconds over there, and it gives you 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Or if you have set it for 1 minute, it would give you 60, 59, 58, 57, and this is how it goes on up to the zero. So here also in Python, we will be creating such kind of a program. How it can be created, we will be looking at that in this video. Let's have a look on how it can be created. To create this program, we will be using the time module. So first of all, we need to use import time. So I'll be writing import time over here to use the time module. Now here what I need to do, I need to create a function called as def countdown. In our countdown, we will be passing the seconds, that how many seconds countdown it should be, like the countdown should be of how many seconds, right? After this, what we need to do, we need to create a while loop over here, because obviously it's a countdown, so every time after 1 second the loop will iterate again, right? So we'll be writing while seconds. What we need to do over here is we need to create two variables. We will be counting the value in the minutes and in the seconds. So I'm creating two variables, minutes, comma, seconds. So minutes and seconds is equal to, we will be applying the method of division mode over here. So we'll be writing division mode. Division mode is a function in Python that gives you two things. If we will be passing two parameters. The first parameter would be second, and the second parameter would be 60, because there are 60 seconds in total. So now division mode, what does division mode gives us? Division mode gives us two values over here. The first value is the floor division and the second value is the modulus. Let's understand this logic first, then we will move ahead with our program. So here I have written division mode, and inside that I have passed, let's say I have 120 seconds. I have put a timer of 120 seconds and here number of second is next value is 60, right? The seconds over here are 120 and the next value is 60. Now what do I need to do is, I will be doing it in this way, that I will be writing 120 and I will be dividing it with 60. So 60 two times is 120, the remainder is 0. So in this way, what output we will get, the floor division over here would be this and the remainder over here would be 0. That means it will be 2 minutes. Similarly, if after 1 second, how much the value would be after 1 second? The value would be 119. So if I divide 119 by 60, in that case what would happen, 61 times is 60 over here and the value would be 59. That means the remainder would be 59. So in that case, what would happen here? 1 minute 59 seconds would come. Similarly, for the next iteration, it will be 118. For 118, it would be 1 minute and 58 seconds. In this way, we will be receiving the output, that first of all, we will be receiving the floor division, the value of the floor division. And in the second one, we will be receiving the remainder over here. So this is how our division mode would work. Now let's apply this method in our program. So once we have done it, I'll be creating a variable called as time format, because I will be formatting the values of minutes and seconds over here. And in the strings, I will be writing colon 2D. Now what is colon 2D over here is, that means I want this value up to two decimal places. Again, I'll be putting a colon, because when you display the time over here, you display it in this way, that between the values, between the first value and between the second value, there is a colon in between. So this is the colon that we are using right now. And again, I'll be putting the braces for the second value. The second value is the remainder. For remainder, again, we will be taking a colon and 2D. 2D is again the two decimal places. Once we are done it, we will be writing dot format. Format inside what? Minutes and seconds. So I'll be writing minutes, comma, seconds. So this value will be formatted with minutes and seconds. Once we are done with this, we will print time format. After printing time format, what should happen over here is, there should be a gap of 1 second after next iteration. For next iteration, we will be giving a time dot sleep of 1 second, that after every iteration, like right now if it is 2 minutes, then after 1 second it will be 1 minute 59 seconds, then again after 1 second it will be 1 minute 58 seconds. So here the time dot sleep would be of 1 second, and every time the seconds will be reduced by -1. So sec is equals to sec -1. That means every time the seconds over here will be reduced by 1. Lastly, we will print, once this iteration will stop, we will print stop. And let's call this countdown timer. So countdown, and let me just give the value over here. So you can, let's see, I'm giving right now the value of 5. Okay, so if I run this, I'll get the output 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And lastly, stop. In this way, I'm getting the output. Suppose if I would have given 120 seconds. In that case, it would have given me 2 minutes, 1 minute 59, 1 minute 58, 1 minute 57, 56, 55, 54. And there is a sleep of 1 second every time. This is how it will be printing it for us. So this is how we have created our countdown timer. The method is very simple over here. First of all, we need to import the time. Then we need to create a function called as countdown. Inside that, we need to pass a parameter called as seconds. We need to create a while loop over here so that it iterates up to the seconds are not zero. Once they become zero, in that case, what we need to do is we need to create two variables. Once it becomes zero, what it will do, it will stop the countdown. Now, next, if it is not zero, till then, what it needs to do is we need to create two variables over here, that is minutes, comma, seconds. That is equals to division mode over here. Division mode means that we will be getting two values from this division mode. We will be passing two parameters. The first parameter is a number that we have to divide, and the second parameter is a number with which we have to divide it. And we'll be getting the output in two values. That means the first value would be the flow division, and the second value over here would be our remainder. Once we are done with this, we will do the formatting by two decimal places. Once we are formatted, we will print the time, give a sleep of 1 second because it's a countdown timer. So after every second, the time should change. So we'll be giving a sleep of 1 second. And every time, the number of seconds will reduce by one. That means after every iteration, the number of seconds will reduce by one. So I hope, guys, this program was clear to you and you have no doubts in the questions. The link of this code is present in our description. And for more such interesting videos, stay connected, guys. Thank you.